Hi! The beautiful Morph animated intro slide you will learn to create today looks like this. Isn't this beautiful? Once you finish showing the introduction, you can close the slide like this and you can move on to the remaining presentation. It is surprisingly easy to create this beautiful Morph animation. Let us learn how to do this from scratch. Here I am on a new slide. The first thing I'm going to do is to go to Auto Shapes Gallery and pick up the line tool, hold the shift button as I draw a horizontal line. Now, this line needs to be right in the middle of the slide. So let me go to Align and say Align Middle. Now, this line is just to guide us. Let us go to Auto Shapes Gallery once again, pick up the rectangle tool and let us draw a rectangle that aligns with this line beautifully and it covers the top half of the slide. Excellent. Now let us duplicate the shape by using Ctrl D shortcut and then move the duplicate to cover the bottom half of the slide. Now we don't really require this straight line. Let us delete that. Now let me select both these shapes and go to Shape Outline and say No Outline. Here you can choose any color you want for these two halves. Let me select this and choose a bright blue color. And this one again is a bright blue color. Now let us go to the Home tab, go to Select and go to Selection Pane so we can name these two rectangles. The top one will be called Blue Top and the bottom one is of course Blue Bottom. This is just so we can recognize these shapes a little later. Now I'm going to make a duplicate of these two shapes again by pressing Ctrl D and I'm going to place them right on top of the previous shape. Now let us have these in a different color. Let us select this and give this maybe this bright orange color and this one needs to be in the same color. Now let us name these shapes. Let us call the top one as Orange Top. And let us call the bottom one as Orange Bottom. Now let us make a copy of these two once again by pressing Ctrl D and I'm going to place them right above the previous ones and I'm going to have them in black color. Once again, let us give the top one a different name. Let us call this Black Top and the bottom one as Black Bottom. Now before we go to the next step, the one thing I'm going to do now is to select all these shapes, hold Ctrl and Shift button as we click and drag from the corner so we are able to increase their size substantially and this is a very important one. Now we have got our shapes ready so we can create a beautiful pattern using these shapes. Let us create a duplicate of the slide by right clicking and using Duplicate Slide option. I'm going to work with these shapes one layer at a time. So let me click on this eye icon so I don't really have to see any of the colors apart from the first one, the blue color. Right click and go to size and position option. And I'm going to rotate them by minus 15 degrees. Then I'm going to arrange in such a way that this corresponds with the top right corner. Can you see here? This is top right corner here. So I've moved it in such a way that this blue rectangle covers this corner portion. Now I'm going to do the same thing here. I'm going to adjust this so it covers the bottom left corner. The first rectangle is done. Now let us once again go back to the selection pane. I don't really need this blue top here, so I'm going to click on these eye icons. Let us work with this orange top. Let us uncheck these eye icons so we can see them. This time I'm going to rotate them by minus 12 degrees. So let us right click, go to size and position and let us have this as minus 12 degrees and hit enter. Once again, I'm going to move this so that it covers the top half, but then I'm going to adjust the angles ever so slightly like this. So you can see I'm not putting this right in the corner. I'm just moving it ever so slightly down just to create a little bit of variation. Now we have got this bit done. Very simple. Let us go to the selection pane and let us work with the last one, which is the black colored rectangles. Let us select both of these, right click, go to size and position, and this time I'm going to rotate them by just 10 degrees. Once again, we are going to do the same thing as we did before. Make a little bit of adjustment in terms of their angles. Just play with the place where you're going to have them positioned. Now, there is no fixed position where you need to keep these rectangles. It is up to you to experiment with their various positionings. Now, let us go to the selection pane again and have them all shown by clicking on Show All Position. Now, when I go to Slideshow, I can see that these rectangles have created a nice looking pattern and you can see the various colors here. Excellent. Now we are going to take this to the next level by doing two things. One, we are going to have a video playing in the background. And second, we are going to have morph transition. So this really opens up in a very nice dramatic way. Now to insert a video, let us go to the first slide itself. Go to insert, go to video and say stock video. Of course, you can choose the video source the way you like. You can get it from pixabay.com, pexels.com, it doesn't really matter. I'm going to use the stock ones available directly from PowerPoint. The video that I chose earlier is this one. Let me select that and say insert. And that places the video exactly where I need it to be placed, which is on the slide area. Now to check if the position is correct or not, you can always see the thumbnail view. Let me increase the size. You can see that it is positioned perfectly. Now, let me make a copy of this and go to the next slide and paste it by pressing Ctrl V. Let me right click and send this to back. Now this is how the second slide would look. Now with this thumbnail as our guidance, let us write some text. Pick up the text box tool from AutoShapes Gallery and write something like welcome to, and let us have these three dots. And let me increase the size. I can even choose a different font, maybe something like 2cm empty condensed extra bold is good. Let me increase the size and let me rotate this like this, and I can place it over here and I can change the font color so it is visible. Of course, I can make the fine tuning of the angle by right clicking and going to size and position, and by using these up arrows, I can go here and make sure that it is all perfectly positioned. Now let me write my text here at the bottom, and you can see from this view that it is placed perfectly. Let me copy by pressing Ctrl D and then move it down, and I'm going to call this Ram's Bakery. I don't really need to have this at an angle, so let us go to 0 degrees. And I'm going to place it, and I will be using this as my guidance, and you can see that it is perfectly positioned. Now I need to add morph transition to get everything in place. Now before that, let me select these two elements, press Ctrl C. Let us go back to the previous slide. Let me right click and send this to back and press Ctrl V and keep these outside the slide area. So I'm going to have this moved out of the slide area. You can see that there is no text here in the previous slide where there is no morph transition. In the next slide, when we add morph transition by going to transitions and morph, you can see that the text comes from outside. Now we have done all that is required. Let us go to the first slide. Let us go to slideshow and see how the animation plays. On a click, you can see that this is how the animation plays. It's a beautiful looking animation. Now, if you want to close this slide dramatically, all you need to do is to go back to the first slide, right click, copy, and then come back here and paste it right after the second slide. Now, I just need to add morph transition to this one as well by going to transitions, morph, and that is all. And it's a beautiful dramatic close. Now, let us go to the first slide and go to slideshow to see our completed work. On a click, you can see we have this dramatic introduction of our bakery. And once I finish talking about the introduction, I can click and that nicely closes and gives this beautiful effect that will take me to the subsequent slides. If you liked this morph transition, you will really love a short playlist of videos that we have put together for you that showcase the power of morph transition in PowerPoint. All you need to do is to click on the link here to start playing the playlist and learn how to use morph transition like a pro. So go ahead, click on the link here and start watching the videos right now.